Welcome to the second part of this series in which we are going to answer the animation aspect of our information technology past paper for May-June 2024. In the previous part, we looked at a graphics creation aspect which dealt with drawing this whole cake and drawing a sliced version of it. In this video, we are going to learn how to animate text on top of a cake. If you're an A-level candidate and you're watching this, it is assumed that at least you have some basic knowledge of how to work in Adobe Animate. For the purpose of those who are new to Adobe Animate as well, I'm going to use the most basic techniques in solving this question. And if you feel the video is going too fast, you can always pause and replay. So let's go and open Adobe Animate and come back to the question. Task 3. Create an animation advertising a service that allows you to add your message on top of a cake. Set the stage to 640 pixels by 480 pixels. Use cake-based PNG as the background. Add a text, your message here, in a gray serif font in the position and size shown. You must animate the text to change color on top of the cake. Start the animation after 1 second. Then it must take 2 seconds to override the gray text with white text, moving from left to right. Then it must take 2 seconds to override the white text with red text, moving from left to right. The animation must be incremental and loop continuously. Save your animation as an animated GIF named Cake Message, followed by your center number, candidate number. So I'll be using Animate 2022 for this video, and the first thing we are going to do is to create the stage. So first thing is go to File, New, and where it asks for the dimensions, you enter what is required, which is the 640 by width and 480 by height. You can leave the frame rate at 30 frames per second, and then you click on Create. So now let's head to where it gives us the stage size, top right corner, and say fit in window. So this is the actual stage size. Now, if you've created a stage as I've done and your workspace is not looking like mine, you can head to the top right corner where you see this workspace icon. Click on it once and select basic. So the first thing I'm going to do is to import the image we are given in the source folder onto the stage. And to do that, we head to File, Import, and select Import to Stage. And within the source folder, I'm going to select Cake Base and click Open. You can see it fits directly onto the stage. We can now head down to the Layers panel, double click on where it says Layer 1, and rename it to Cake Base. We now need to create a new layer that will hold our text. So click on this plus button. Make sure the layer is selected. Pick your type tool. And you can give the fill any color for now. So I'm leaving mine as black. And make sure it's a serif font. So to be on a safer side, I'm going to type in Times New Roman, because that's the font I want to use, and reduce the size from what I have here to say 40. Click on the stage and then type in your message here. Now I can make changes to the font by double clicking and selecting the entire font, we can change it from the regular to bold. And when we come down to paragraph here, we can drop this down and change it from left align to center align. So we can now head back to the layers panel and change the name layer 2 here by double clicking it. Let's rename it to message to create some distinction between the two. Next, we are going to create the layers that will hold the different colors that are going to be displayed in our text animation. And to do this, we are going to create 3 different rectangles on 3 different layers. So let's head to the layers panel and begin with the first layer, which will be for the gray color of the text. So I'll click on this plus sign to create a new layer and rename it to gray. Then I'll pick my rectangle tool, and under the properties panel, under the tools tab, where you see fill, I change the color over there to gray. Then we come to our stage and draw a rectangle over the message like this. We will now create an additional layer, which is for the white, which will move over the gray layer in 2 seconds. So once again, I click on the new layers button and change the layer name to white. Pick the rectangle tool, and under the properties panel, change the fill to white. You can now go ahead and draw your white rectangle and make sure it fits exactly above the gray rectangle. They should be of the same size. Now, since our animation must start after 1 second and the white must move over the gray in 2 seconds, I'm going to give the gray layer a 3 seconds frame. So on the gray layer, we select the gray layer, go to the 3 seconds. You can add a frame or 2 after the 3 seconds, and then you say insert frame, because that is how long our gray layer is supposed to last. Now the movement of our white layer must begin after 1 second. So on the white layer, I go to the 1 second mark and insert a keyframe. You can see the white layer here. But what I'm going to do is move the white layer to the edge of the gray layer, like this. So its movement will begin from here. Then we move 2 seconds ahead to the 3 second mark, and we insert another keyframe. And then we move our white to cover the gray. After that, we right click anywhere in the middle of the white layer between the 1 to the 3 second mark and create a classic tween. The symbol warning will come, and just click OK. Now, if I move my playhead from the 1 second mark to the 3 second mark, you see it covers the gray. Now, before we add the last layer, let's expand our cake base to fill the entire animation. So the animation is going to last 5 seconds in total. So I'm going to come to the 5 second mark on the cake base layer and say insert frame. Now let's go ahead and add our next layer. Let's place that above the white layer, rename it to red. And the red will start appearing, I think, from the 3 second mark onwards to cover the white. So on the 3 second mark, I insert a keyframe, pick my rectangle tool, and change the fill to red. Now I'm going to draw a rectangle to cover the white and pick my move tool and move the rectangle to the edge of the white. And move 2 seconds ahead where it says 5, and then I'll insert a keyframe. Then I'll move my entire rectangle into position. Once again, I'll click in between and create a classic tween. So I'm going to extend the white a bit. I'm just going to add a frame. And we can do the same for the gray. Now we need to move our message layer above all the layers. And on the last keyframe, which is the 5 second mark, we enter a keyframe. So you still have our message showing. Next, we need to create a mask for all the rectangles we've created. So after we've placed our message above all the rest, right click on message and select mask. First, the red layer is directly masked under it. So to apply it to the white and the gray, you just click and drag beneath the red. Do the same for the gray, click and drag beneath the white. And for the masking to take effect on the additional two layers, you just click on the padlocks here. Now, as we play back, let's see. Now it plays well, but we realize that there's an error at the very beginning. It begins with white and then it starts with a gray here. It's supposed to start with gray. So what we are going to do is we are going to remove this keyframe so that it begins with the gray instead. So what we are going to do is click on the keyframe and you can say insert blank keyframe. You see it becomes gray, but still at the very beginning, the white keyframe is there. So we are just going to click on it once, right click. And then we say clear keyframe. Now let's play back once again. So we have our gray and then our white comes in 2 seconds, then our red 2 seconds. Now our question further states that the animation must be incremental and loop continuously. So incremental means it must have a smooth movement. It must not be an abrupt animation from one instance to the other. And for it to loop continuously, it means it must not have a stop, an obvious stop and start, but it must just be continuous. Okay, so let's go back into Animate. And let's go to our publish settings under properties. And let's click on more settings. Now, since we are going to export it as an animated GIF, let's click on GIF image, select it. And where it says playback, you change it from static to animated. And after you've done that, make sure loop continuously is selected and smooth as well. After we're done with that, we can just click OK and head back to file, export, and select exports animated GIF. Let's make a quick reference to the name we are supposed to use, cake message. Click on save. Let's select the folder we need to use. And let's add the name, followed by your center number and your candidate number. Then we click on save. You can now head into your folder and open the animation and check if it's playback, it's okay. So if you follow this tutorial correctly, this should be your end result. So what we've learned in this video is how to create classic tweens and how to mask multiple layers under one layer. I hope you've enjoyed this video and I hope you've learned something new in addition to what we've done. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so and see you in the next video.